kind of introduced to this whole new world of crazy animals that look like aliens, that have all these different life history stages, life cycles, and I got hooked.
Zooplankton are the base of the food web and of life in Puget Sound.
Zooplankton are really tiny marine animals, and they can be found throughout the water column.
Pretty much anything that comes out of the ocean is eating something that eats zooplankton or eating zooplankton directly.
When the juvenile chinook come out of the Nisqually River and into deeper water, the zooplankton we're catching today are what they're going to be looking to eat.
So the Puget Sound Zooplankton Monitoring Program started because there just wasn't a lot known of what kind of zooplankton were out there, where they were, how many.
We don't have a lot of historical data on zooplankton in Puget Sound. And there's never been something like this where we have groups all around Puget Sound, all the way up to the San Juan Islands, collecting zooplankton regularly.
Once we're done collecting these samples, we hand them off to University of Washington, and they use those counts to estimate abundance in the water out here today.
We wouldn't be able to do this program without the engagement of so many different partners, and those partners include tribes, NGOs, state and federal, county. A large group of people have recognized the importance of this work and really put a lot of effort into it.
Working for the Nisqually Indian tribe, we're involved in a lot of the different elements of salmon, their life history and what it takes for them to succeed.
It's important baseline information that we really need to understand what's happening in the ecosystem and then respond appropriately.
What's going on in Puget Sound? What are we finding in different places? How it's changing throughout the year and from year to year, and how things are changing with the climate.
These zooplankton that we're out here counting and monitoring are one of the critical food sources for Chinook. So the status and the trends in zooplankton can double or cut in half the number of fish that return the next year.
These types of programs are sometimes rare, but their value really builds as time and more data is accumulated.
My hopes for this monitoring program are that we can learn a lot about what zooplankton might be available for fish, juvenile salmon to eat, as well as combining our data with the Canadian folks so we can really get an understanding, say, the seawide of what is happening with zooplankton.
When we're increasing understanding of the health of Puget Sound, it lets people know what needs to be addressed. Good policy needs to start with good science.